Welcome to all. In this video, we are going to see that how does internet works. We all think that the internet is based on cloud, but the actual fact is that the internet is not based on cloud. It is actually made up of wires from the underground of the earth like fiber optics and copper cables. Then how the computers communicate? If the two computers want to communicate, it's communicate through the network. Then, what is network? A network consists of two or more computers that are linked in order to share resources such as printers and CDs, which exchange files or allows electronic communications. The computer on a network may be linked through cables, telephone lines, radio waves, satellites or infrared light beams. For example, of network is internet. And then what is internet? As we said, if the two computers want to communicate, it's communicate through the network. If the millions of computers want to connect to each other, it communicates through the internet, as it is called as interconnected network. The internet is a global system of interconnected computer networks that uses the internet protocol TCP or IP to communicate between networks and devices. It is a massive network of networks. It connects millions of computers together globally, forming a network in which any computer can communicate with any other computer as long as they are both connected to the internet. In short, we can say that the internet has shrunk the world. So, how does it actually work? The internet is a worldwide computer network that transmits a variety of data and media across the interconnected devices. It works by using a packet routing network that follows the internet protocol IP and transport control protocol TCP. This TCP and IP work together to ensure that data transmission across the internet is consistent and reliable, no matter which device you are using or where you are using it. When data is transferred over the internet, it's delivered in mass messages and packets. Data sent over the internet is called a message. But before the messages get sent, they are broken up into the tinier parts called packets. These mass messages and packets travel from one source to the next using the internet protocol IP and transport control protocol TCP. A IP is a system of rules that govern how information is sent from one computer to another computer over an internet connection. Using a numerical address, IP address, the IP system receives further instructions on how the data should be transferred. A protocol, TCP, works with IP to ensure transfer of data is dependable and reliable. This helps to make sure that no packets are lost. These packets are reassembled in proper sequence and there is no delay negatively affecting the data quality. Let us describe in step by step. In step 1, your PC or device is connected to the web through a modem or router. Together, these devices allow you to connect to other networks around the globe. A router enables multiple computers to join the same network, while a modem connects to your ISP, which is called Internet Service Provider, which provides you with either cable or DSL internet. Type in a web address known as a URL, which is called Uniform Resource Locator. Each website has its own unique URL that signals to your ISP where you want to go. And then your query is pushed to your ISP, which is called Internet Service Provider, which connects to the several servers, which is the ideal computer, which store and send data like NAP server, network access protection, and a DNS, which is called domain name server. Next, your browser looks up the IP address for the domain name you typed into your search engine through DNS. This DNS then translates the text-based domain name you type into the browser into the number-based IP address. For example, if you type a google.com, which is called as a domain name, it becomes IP address, which is named 64.233.9191.255. A browser sends a hypertext transfer protocol, which is called HTTP, which is application layer protocol, request to the target server to send a copy of the website to the client using TCP or IP. The server then approves request and sends a 200 OK message to a computer. Then the server sends a website files to the browser in the form of data packets. As your browser reassembles the data packets, the website loads, allowing to learn, shop, browse and engage. Then it is the final results. Thanks for watching.